It is the same Welsh team that faced Scotland. Not so much a vote of confidence as a demand to make amends. A 50th cap for Justin Tipperick. George North singled out this week as one who must do more, better. High-risk man management. Reece Webb singled out as a scrum half in prime form. Ireland 2 unchanged. It is a vote of confidence. In forwards like CJ Stander, nobody has carried more than him in the Six Nations. Keith Earls has scored 5 tries in his last 5 games for Ireland. Conor Murray against Reece Webb could be one of the personal jewels of the championship. The finishes, unless required earlier. Paddy Jackson has been the most successful kicker in Test rugby in the past year. Sam Davis will bring his running game to the last quarter. Wayne Barnes of England is tonight's referee. Dan Biggar alongside the referee. Wales in red, Ireland in green. It's a traditional Celtic fixture. Joe Schmidt, Rob Howley, the coaches.
Rory, time to run, fellas.
Round 4 of the RBS Six Nations. Wales against Ireland. Simon Zeebo waits, catches. Conor Murray.
Pushed him in. Don't
Devin
push
Toner. Right in the middle of the field. Options on either side. O'Brien, good pass from him. CJ Stander couldn't quite get it away. Advantage Ireland.
High tackle. Knock on him, just a bit high risk.
The knock on, followed by a high tackle. Scrum becomes a penalty.
High tackle.
Big line speed there from Wales, and that's what you'd expect this early in the game. It's going to be a big challenge for Ireland to hold on to the ball if the ball is wet, and Wales are getting off the line really hard as well. And here we have the long-range kick. It's funny because going back into the autumn, Ireland would have taken these into the corner every time, and even at the start of the championship, they've taken these kicks and they've gone to the corner. So an interesting change of tactics here.
If you're standing in
the line, there's a high shot. You know, there's a knock-on in the tackle by Dan Biggar. We have to, you know, the Irish attack again, asking.
Holds its line, Ireland take the lead.
And as Ireland do, they've taken, they put, turn the pressure into points.
Henshaw. Zeebo, high to Keith Earls, puts him in an awkward position. Earls had no option but to kick. George North wants the ball from Halfpenny and receives it. Good line speed from even Devon Toner. Scott Williams to his centre partner, Jonathan Davis. Gets the pass off the ground to Justin Tipperick. Williams again. Bigger. Dares to pass one. Zeebo has it. Skips out of the tackle of Rob Evans, puts the kick in. Biggar heads back.
22.
And it's a 22 dropout.
That's very, very well played with Dan Biggar. It's not the position you want to be in. Is it going to roll dead? Isn't it? There's an Irish player following you. Just watch him. He just watches. He goes to ground. Just kind of cajoles the ball over the line. That's very, very good play.
Yeah, it was. I thought it was the perfectly way to kick.
There he is, just wait. Brilliant play, brilliant play. Dangerous, but brilliant.
Cool nerves. Oh,
absolutely, great play.
Toner, brought down by Warburton. Sexton stays down. Murray has to clear. Bigger, will he take it quickly? He won't.
This will be a
Johnny Sexton will have time to get himself sorted.
Well, he's had a couple of big tackles. You know, I saw the whites of Sam Walton's eyes light up when he saw he had a chance to smash Sexton earlier. Then he had to catch a high ball, he got hit as well. And this again, he goes to ground. I think he copped one in on the eye. Look at his left eye, I think he's going to swell up. Look.
Oh, he didn't see a touch.
Left knee caught the left knee of Jonathan Dear. Just watch. I don't know what he did.
Well, it's a very undignified place for an outside half.
Yeah, you've got to try and avoid those places at a standoff. You know,
yeah, he just seems to be in the wars every game, you know. It's not something Ireland need, you know, in a big game like this. You want that experienced man on the field.
And Paddy Jackson will come on because Johnny Sexton will have to go off for the head injury assessment.
I'm sure he'll be okay. He's had a huge influence on the game so far. The variety of his play, you know, he's asking a lot of questions of the Welsh defence, with their coping admirably at the moment.
Got potential foul play. Okay. I don't know what I'm looking at, so just point
this
in the right direction.
Jérôme Garcés, the touch judge.
Footage coming up now.
Ben Skeen is the television match official.
A potential.
Number 10, Johnny Sexton, is replaced by number 22, Paddy Jackson.
What am I looking at?
So here it comes now, Barnsley.
That is nothing.
It's Barnsley. It's accidental.
Yeah, I totally agree.
It's accidental, yeah. But contact has been made.
The name of the game, really.
He's just running to the ball.
I've heard Wayne Barnes describe this as a rugby collision. I don't think there's anything in it.
Yeah, it's not a tackle, mate. They're just running for the ball. Thanks for putting it up on the screen, but we're just going to carry on with that, OK?
He's come all the way from New Zealand. He wants to be here on television, doesn't he? So, you know, just...
No. Oh, Sam Warburton wins the line-out. Ross Moriarty to Rhys Webb. And it's worked because Scott Williams is through. Webb in support. Long pass to Lee Halfpenny. Halfpenny to George North. North is back with a vengeance.
It's like they've listened to Jeremy Guscott's pre-match analysis, because off the break, Rhys Webb was right up the field. He was just beside Scott Williams just as he made the break and was able to make it. Here he is. That's exactly what Jeremy Guscott was chatting about before the game. Fantastic pass. Absolutely fantastic pass and a great finish from North.
Again, this is what you want to see. What the finish. That is a brilliant finish. But what I'm so happy to see, great support play into passing. That's brilliant vision. These are the support runners they've lacked in past games. What the finish. What the finish on George North.
And what does it mean to the wing to be back in that fashion?
Joe Smith spoke during the week about George North. You know, you have a world-class player that doesn't play well or isn't playing.
Drama. Lee Halfpenny misses the conversion. Wales, though, are in the lead. 5-3.
It's one of his.
Toner again sets up the driving maul.
Not a side, and that's once.
CJ Stander against Tipperick. Another penalty against Tipperick.
Clearly come off the ball, please.
Yeah. You know, he's got to release the ball, hasn't he, when he's tackled him.
Yeah, that's two, mate.
Yeah, they're going for the post.
Just a little
3 points.
Caution wins the day, and Ireland are going for the posts.
It's an easier kick as well, you know, it's a difficult kick from what it was. So this is an easier kick. You take the 3 points and just, you know, put your nose in front. They've got to release there, haven't they? Got to release the tackle, at least the ball didn't do it.
Out of his last 13. 14 out of 14. Ireland take the lead at the principal. Jake Ball again. Good Irish defence. Stops the lock in his tracks. Justin Tipperick Wales keeping it tight. There's not many options of width.
This is where the
Ken Owens.
The vision's got to be to run at corner.
Warburton. Jake Ball. No knock
advantage.
On. It is a penalty for Wales at last. And it is the kick by Webb to Halfpenny. Jonathan Davis a foot short. Advantage again. Yellow card.
No, clearly killed the ball on the line. Clearly killed the ball on the line. Clearly killed the ball on the line.
Johnny Sexton is going into the bin. Clearly killing the ball on the line. Leo Williams gives him a pat as
he... There's one here, or there's one in the middle of the post. You can take which one you want.
Heads for the bin. Wayne Barnes give Wales the option. Penalty in the corner.
One here.
Or in front of the post. They're taking the one in front.
Treatment here again now, and I really think if Wales had managed to get out and had Scott Williams running at him or Jonathan Davis running, he wouldn't have been able to make the tackle.
As it is, Lee Halfpenny lands the penalty and Wales take the lead. Oh, it's been an exhilarating half. It's had a bit of everything. It's had this very near try. Jonathan Davis so close to the line. Now Johnny Sexton on the ground and he's caught there. And again, it's no place for an outside half to be, really.
He cannot get out of there.
No.
Look, there's no way he can get out. And in fairness, we've heard Wayne Barnes saying a few times, you're holding him in, you're holding him in, and he hasn't penalised guys, but...
Again. He's lit, knocks it on, comes loose, bounces away from Rob Carney.
Knock on.
Half-time. Well, there haven't been that many points, but it's been full of just about everything you want from a Friday night game in the Six Nations. At half-time, Wales 8, Ireland 6. It up. Webb for Scott Williams to chase. Conor Murray has to turn. Lee Halfpenny in hot pursuit. Murray tackled so close to the line. Just about finds touch. So Murray did very well there, but what a clever kick that was.
Clever, clever kick. You have to say, before that kind of loose pass, Ireland were playing very clever football. We do forget that Sexton's off the pitch, so they were a man short. But that one mistake, they ran out of patience, poor execution, and now they're right under the cosh in their own 5 metres.
Big moment here, 5 metre drive.
Ken Owens prepares to throw 5 metres from the Irish line. Alan Wynne-Jones. And the ball is on. Alan Wynne-Jones with the ball. It's there. North for a second try.
These are such massive moments in the game. Ireland had two cracks in the first half. Wales stole one of their lineouts, defended the next one. Wales get their first crack at a 5 metre drive here. And in fairness, they scored really comfortably. The lineout move was set up. Here it is. It's set up so well. It looks so tight that the Irish have to commit numbers. They're down a man, and that man, they make that man tell.
It's communication, isn't it? It's great communication. Reece Webb has the vision that there's nobody on the short side. He sucks Zeebo in and he scores. And as Paul said about Wales, you know, releasing pressure, making a mistake. Ireland were in control of the ball, the one loose pass. Wales capitalise on it. Great kick and chase.
Holds its line. Wales extend their lead. 15 points to 6. They have found scoring very difficult in their last two games. Not here tonight. George North, well, if he plays like this, he's probably guaranteed himself a public flogging every game.
What a way to respond, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a big, big hill to climb now for Ireland.
And Wales turn it over. Knock on. No penalty.
OK, after a run.
Yes, it is.
It is a penalty, spotted by the touch judge on that far side.
Absolutely exhausting phase of play there. And up until that penalty, I thought it was incredible defence by Wales. To let go through those phases, hold them out, not give away a penalty is absolutely fantastic play. And now we're back to 5 metre drives again. My favourite part of the game, Jiffy. What do you think?
I have to, it's a great defence, but I have to say, Johnny Sexton, how he manages the whole Irish backline, his choice of passes brilliant. He makes a significant difference to this side.
Toner.
Tackle is good, tackle is fair.
And it's play on so far. It's there for Marmion. Sean O'Brien. Sam Warburton tries to grab the ball. Ringrose.
High tackle.
A sort of accidental high tackle. The penalty is still given. It's still a high tackle, says Wayne Barnes.
They'll have to go.
I'll speak to you in a second. Go for goal.
Sam Warburton is getting through some amount of work. Some amount of high quality.
He's been off for treatment. He's been off in the bin. But he's back. Masterminding the Irish comeback. 15 points to 9.
There were two scores. They needed two scores. That's...
Give the signal.
Charteris is an intimidating figure there when you're trying to call the lineup.
Henderson wins. Charteris very much. Well, he's been blocked out by Henderson. Clever play by Ireland. They've stopped Charteris getting near the ball, and on comes the drive from Rory Best. That's not anything, it's still moving. Rory Best edges closer. Help arrives from the outside. I think it's a penalty to Wales.
Explain, okay. The Moore's going forward, lovely, it's end stop. Number 12's run from a distance in front of the ball and made it start going again. That's obstruction, that's a penalty.
Well, 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 that is... I think the forwards will be absolutely crazy because it seemed to be going in the right direction, seemed to be slowly, slowly that stop. Then Henshaw comes in and goes in front of the ball and reignites the drive again. He's disallowed it and given the penalty.
No, I didn't see it like Paul? That, I thought you were going quite well. Stop, and then 12 started it.
I think he has a point. We haven't seen it again here, but he has to bind over the guy at the back of the mall. So here he comes.
Oh,
yeah. Oof. It's harsh enough.
Well, he's
harsh
in enough. From the side.
If he had put an arm over the top of Rory Best, as
he tries to raise his legs, but Justin Tipperick hangs on, and Ireland still in their 22.
Discipline.
And again, Tipperick involved. Sean O'Brien. Took a little pause. Can't get out of the 22.
Hands away now!
Rory Best. Ireland standing still and taking the ball. Is there any way out of this 22? Ireland trail by 6 points. Sexton, the charge down by Faletau. Jamie Roberts for the line! Roberts! We wait for Wayne Barnes to award the try. He has, and Wales have just won the encounter.
Well, it's a pressure from Faletau. Fresh legs. He gets to Sexton. Sexton has tried every pass in the book to unlock this defence. But then he tries the little chip. Faletau, I think, gets to him. And there's the try scorer.
Yeah, I mean, fair play to Wales. They've been really, really clever in the second half. They exited from the penalty. Excellent driving ball to a box kick, and they've just pinned Ireland down there and put them under incredible pressure.
Jamie Roberts. Lee Halfpenny adds the 2 points. Wales are over 20. Jonathan, your man of the match.
Yeah, I think, you know, Warburton's been brilliant. So I say.
Jonas, thank you. Crouch. Oh. Bind. Set.
Oh. If it's a retreating scrum and Ireland have stolen it. We're into overtime.
Thanks, mate. Tackle!
Ireland come away with it. Play goes on. Alan Wynne-Jones still working. No let-up in the pace at all. Paddy Jackson. No let-up in the ferocity of the tackling.
Now you've pushed him back in.
Niall Scannell.
Still in.
Replacement hooker. Paddy Jackson goes on his own. Oh, it's a good tackle by Scott Baldwin, the hooker.
No.
Henderson. Tackled by Gareth Davis. Marmion. Sean O'Brien.
And away.
And still, it thunders on through Peter Omani. Gone forward at last. Well, if Wales can break away and score, they get themselves a bonus point. It could be Sam Davis is on. Jamie Roberts, George North, cuts inside. North, a burst of acceleration. George North! Up to the Irish 22, Gareth Davis waits. Davis. Halfpenny, Jonathan Davis, men outside him, can't get the pass away, he does now. Chartres was there. Scott Baldwin.
And hands away now, Ireland.
Davis goes darting round the blind side. Halfpenny twists, rolls, presents Jonathan Davis at scrum half, the captain. Sam Davis knocks on, the game is over. Wales don't get their bonus point, but they do have the victory in a pulsating, enthralling game. They have beaten Ireland by 20...